Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to yet another edition of Musical Postcards for Seniors. We have a very special treat for you this afternoon, and we are so happy to be here in your rooms with you. Here we are in pandemic 2020, COVID-19, and we designed this show from Falmouth Academy to bring some of our star musicians right into your room, courtesy of cable TV. And we'd like to welcome a new cable partner this week, and that is Bourne Community TV. Welcome to all of you at the Cape Cod Senior Residence and Bourne Community. Thank you for joining us, and we know you're going to enjoy this show. One of the things I like most about preparing this show is that this is an all-student presentation. We have engineers, we have editors, we have student artists. I think this is show 8. We do a half an hour show every week, and we're all working from our own homes completely remotely. And that has led to an interesting series of technical problems. But tune in next week for the final show of the season, and we'll talk about some of those funny things that have happened. Right now, we're going to get to the music. And I know you're going to love this young man that we have. He's a multi-instrumentalist and a composer and a fascinating young man and great hair. He has great hair, so you can tell I love him right off the bat. And we're going to start him off today with a song by Joop Beving. Now, this fellow's name is Joop, J-O-E-P, last name Beving, and he's a Danish composer. And this is a very emotional piece of music, and I really think you're going to love it. The student artist this week is from Plymouth, and his name is James Goldbach. He is a junior at Falmouth Academy. And in this piece, as I said, he's going to be playing piano, but you're going to be hearing him play many different things during this show. So let's please welcome now, James Goldbach. James,
that was Mr. Shar.
that was really a touching, emotional piece of music.
I know.
Tell me, let's talk about the music first, and then we're dying to get to know you. Tell me about Yoke. This is not a composer I had heard of until you brought him to my attention.
Right, and he's actually a pretty obscure composer. He hasn't made many popular pieces. He's a Danish composer, so we don't hear of him all that much in America either. But locally, he's created a lot of music for small television shows and things like that. But this particular piece, he didn't create for any specific reason. This was one of his earlier pieces, actually. And I discovered this through a friend, actually, who went to Falmouth Academy, Ian Hinkle, who showed me this piece. Yeah, I know. And I heard him playing a part of it one day, and he showed it to me, and I fell in love with it because it's a really beautiful and, you know, dramatic piece, very like cinematic and epic and sad and all those great things. And so he wrote it to actually kind of be a story of his experience through his early life, or at least that's what the description of the song said. And you can kind of hear that in the tone of the piece. At the beginning, it starts off softer and slower and gets to the middle, which is very strong and powerful. And then at the end, it calms down again, where he kind of reaches contentment in his life.
James, that was that in 2 minutes and 30 seconds, there's a lot of emotion that he, like you described, the flow of the piece, how it starts calm and it climaxes and it ends beautifully. You know, this piece, as I recall, he released in 2017, and a quick YouTube search shows 170,000 views on this piece of music. And it kind of reflects his personality too. He's a quiet, kind of a laid back guy. Just a beautiful, inspirational music and terrific piano playing. Thank you for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
James, you are quite a musician. As I said earlier, you're a junior at Falmouth Academy, and you play in our advanced instrumental ensemble, and you also compose music. Isn't that correct?
I wouldn't call it composing. I would more call it producing, because when I think composing, I think, you know, Bach writing music in his study and, you know, composing these big, you know, symphony orchestra pieces. But I do make my own music. I write my own music in GarageBand and put it together. So yes.
So let's explain to our audience that GarageBand is a software that that's on the computer, and you can type in notes and play them back and arrange them and so forth. And it's it really has enabled, let me put it this way, Mozart wrote 640 pieces of music without computer. If he had a computer, he probably would have written 640 in about a weekend.
Yeah.
Maybe Memorial Day week. I don't know. So you definitely are a composer. You certainly, I've heard some of your work, and we're going to play some of that for you now. Now, in addition to your composing abilities, you also have technical abilities. So you've developed a set of skills through GarageBand and through video where you can actually play more than one instrument at the same time. Tell me how that works. How do you do that?
Right. So there's a couple different ways that you can achieve that. So one way is that with this GarageBand software, I can play my saxophone into the microphone and it records it. And then I can play another instrument like my piano under that instrument, and that will record the same thing. So then I can play back both of them at the same time. And so I can basically do that an infinite amount of times and create as many instruments as I want, create as big a band as I want just with one person.
Wow. Now, not only that, I know you play the drums, so you can play the drums, you can play the piano, you can play the bass guitar, you can play the saxophone, so you can build up a band and put it all on a sound or an audio recording, but you can also do it in video, and you can actually show more than one image of yourself.
Of course, yeah.
So set this next lick up for us, and this is the piece that you and Taryn did for a postcard at school. Tell our audience about this.
Okay, so Taryn and I, we were approached by, I think you, right, Mr. Shar, to do this postcard of Amazing Grace. And this was actually the first time I had attempted to kind of arrange one of these square video compilations or, I don't know, flip grid. I don't even know. There's so many words for it. I don't know what to call it, but.
Well, my generation calls it Hollywood Squares, because you've got all of the different images. You don't even remember the Hollywood Squares probably, but all of the different images, like we have on the screen now, our audience is seeing two screens. What we're going to see now is four screens, And James is playing alto on the top two images, and another student, Taryn, is playing tenor sax on the bottom two. And ladies and gentlemen, this is James Goldbach and Taryn playing Amazing Grace. James, that was really cool. So you recorded one track, and then tell me how you got Taryn's tracks and put them together.
So it was actually a pretty complicated process. So each of us individually at our separate houses, which in and of itself is amazing that we were able to do that, recorded videos of playing two different parts. So I played one part and then another part, and then Taryn played another part and another part. And so he sent those over to me. I separated all the video from the audio and I edited them separately. So I edited all the mistakes out of our videos and put them all together so that they were all in synchrony. And then I also synchronized the video to the audio. And so there were many, many steps, but the final product I think turned out pretty good.
It was very good. Fabulous. So that is a terrific segue into this next piece that you're going to play. When we go on tour with our jazz band, we've been doing it about 15 years. We go to the White Mountains. And one of the pieces the kids always like to play is It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. So James is really going to take that to another level. And we're going to call this a self-quartet. So you're going to see here James now playing four different instruments. He's playing piano, bass guitar, drums, and the alto sax. Ladies and gentlemen, here is James Goldbach, James Goldbach, James Goldbach, and James Goldbach in a self-quartet of It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. Thank you. Beautiful saxophone solo and a piano solo too. That is just amazing. James, let's spend a little time now, and I know we're going to hear some of your original music coming up. Let's spend a little time getting to know you, other than your music hobbies, which you have a lot. So you're involved in the athletic program over at Falmouth Academy. What do you do there, and what position do you play? And tell me about that.
So it's shifted over the years, but my going steady sport has been basketball. Mm-hmm. So I've played basketball freshman year through senior year. Well, I haven't played senior year yet, but I'm going to play next year. My freshman year, I played soccer, basketball, and lacrosse. Mm-hmm. My sophomore year, I played just basketball. This year, I played just basketball because lacrosse season was canceled because of COVID. And then next year, I am going to be playing basketball and lacrosse again, and I'm actually going to be the boys varsity captain of the basketball team.
Well, your talents don't end there, because you really have a passion and you excel at another academic subject. What is that?
So my favorite subject is science, and specifically biology. So that's what I've always loved and what I, project to do in the future for probably the rest of my life is something in the scientific field, and I'm hoping medical field. That's what I'm trying to do, is go to med school and do pre-med and undergrad and all that fun stuff.
And as I've told you, I know a lot of musicians who went into medical, which is great. I highly recommend that. And one in particular, a friend of mine right here, he's older than me, a little bit older anyway, and he played his way through college. While he was going to college, he played piano in nightclubs and bars and so forth, and did pretty well.
Yeah.
And he still plays. So having music in your life is very important, and that's why we're doing these shows. So Science Fair at Falmouth Academy is a real big deal. Tell us a little bit, what's that like? Here you are talking to somebody who is a global climate expert, for example. What do you have to do? You have to explain your project, and they vote, they judge you.
It is a very intimidating process, to say the least. But basically, it's a process where you spend a couple months, depending on the complexity of your project, spend, maybe a year, maybe 6 months, maybe 4 months preparing for the science fair, researching, experimenting, doing your own experiment, creating your own hypothesis, and all these things that are kind of a microcosm of what you would do as, in a scientific career, in kind of this, concentrated format, which is really good for students like me who really love stuff like that. And it's helped me in my scientific knowledge and my knowledge of the scientific method so much over the past couple years, and it's been a great experience.
It's fabulous. Well, now you also have an interest in politics. So what just happened to you in a local student election?
Right. So this is a little bit more of a new interest for me. I haven't pursued this up until this year, but I've always kind of been, whether through you or through my friends, very involved in a lot of student functions and school functions. So, I took part in the auction, performing at the auction with a couple of students a couple years back. I'm really involved in setting up the cafe for gala, things like that. And so I've always kind of just gravitated towards helping at those events. And I think that I realized that I kind of wanted to do that as a position next year. So I ran for and won the position of student or vice president of student council for next
vice
year.
President of student council, and student council meets once a week.
Yeah,
it is part of the elective block, and you run a lot of the student activities for the school. We're going to now segue back to music. I'm going to put up a picture here of you and Luca, because you're going to be working with Luca. Look at this picture. This picture was shot a year or two ago as we were putting some promos together, and the chemistry between these two is just terrific. And next week's show, they're going to close the show. Next week's show, like I said, will be a 1 hour special. We'll have 30 plus minutes of music from James and Luca, both individually and together. And you'll be very impressed with the music they play. So as we move now to, you have a couple of pieces of music left for us to play, and I can't wait to hear these because they are original pieces of music and you have written them and you are a composer. This first one, set this up for our audience. I know a little bit about this. It's quite cool.
Thank you. So the creation of this song is a very kind of long and stretched out story that culminated with the creation of this piece that started with freshman year, actually. Me and a group of my really close friends, I had a really close friend group freshman year. And so one day I live near a pond. So we walked down to the pond and it was about dusk. And so it was just getting dark out and we were all swimming in the pond and looking out into the pond. And someone there said, "It looks like we're staring into the edge of the universe," or something along those lines. And it was just a very kind of peaceful and beautiful moment. And I look back on that moment very fondly because some of those friends have graduated. And so I don't really see them anymore. So that was like one of the highlights of my high school career. And so Edie, my friend who lives actually just next door to me, wrote lyrics kind of describing the whole night and the whole scenario in our friend group. And there was even a piece of art that one of our friends, Ruby, drew to also kind of encapsulate that image. So there's a lot of things surrounding this night for us because it was a really special night. So just this year, we came together and in my in-home studio thing in my basement, we sang into this microphone and I created, played some instruments and we created a whole song based on that night.
So this song is called "The Edge of the Universe." And we're going to hear it now, and it features Edie Lever on vocals and James Goldbach on vocals. And James is also playing on this piece guitar, piano, bass, drums, and I think I got it all. Some [S2] Yep. [S1] Of the vocals are double tracked, which means that you'll hear more than one voice. It's kind of echoey. It's very much a pop song. I can see this song making it big. He even put in some ambient wind noises to set the mood. And this was done in his home recording studio. So ladies and gentlemen, here is Edie Lever and James Goldbach, "Edge of the Universe." Thank you. So James, this last piece you're going to do for us is another original composition. And I know composers have to be inspired. Tell us how this came about.
So this piece, I was inspired by nature during, I believe it was last summer. It was very early in the morning. I don't even think I'd had breakfast yet. And I had woken up before sunrise because I had gotten into the very weird habit of doing that. So I was up very early and I had my guitar. And so I went out to sit on my little porch that's right outside my house and just sat down with my guitar and spent maybe an hour or so just coming up with these little licks put together. And eventually it turned into this song. And it's called Golden Green because I was inspired by the super peaceful image of the sun rising and kind of reflecting in the dewdrops on the grass that's in my front yard. So that's why I named it Golden Green.
James, that sounds absolutely lovely and inspirational, and I can't wait to share this with the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of myself, George Shire, your host, and James Goldbach and Edie Lever, Isabel Hurd in engineering, and all the faculty and students who are supporting this program, all of the cable TV networks, all of the nursing homes and senior living residences, we are with you. We're thinking of you. We think of you every day. We want you to know that you're not in this alone. And we hope you enjoy this show many times a week. Come back and see us often. When we get back to brick and mortar schedule, I will bring these students around to play for you live. In the meantime, I will say goodbye until next week, and let's go out with James Goldbach and Golden Green.